Helimed 98 is heading out over the Humber estuary to a serious farm accident. Dr. Brian has few details.
Supposedly, a farmer has impaled his hand on a stake, close proximity to some livestock and slurry.
The patient's reported trapped and bleeding in a pigsty. The team are already planning the farmer's treatment.
So what's your thoughts then, if he's impaled and it's a through and through, what's your thoughts about augmenting?
Well, it'll be bone, it'll be an open bone.
Yeah, so and obviously the risk of the slurry.
Yeah, infection from the slurry, so they'll have antibiotics as well.
Pilot Gary is on final approach to the farm on the remote Holderness Peninsula.
Farmers usually quite a hardy species, isn't it? And if they do complain of anything, you have to take it quite seriously.
Local firefighters have been trying to free the patient.
Worker in here, he must have been hit by a pig, and he's gone down. I think he's braced himself, and it's gone right up there, through there. He's in all the crap.
Okay, mate. Thank you. How are we doing? How are you?
This guy's got his hand stuck on a metal crook where the fence gate goes.
That's from one of those spikes. Okay. That's it, come all the way through up to the top there, the skin, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Farmer Wayne Jackson is in terrible pain. His hand is impaled.
It's only through that bit there.
Matt must examine it to work out how best to free him.
I don't think we're going to be able to sew it. I think we should go with ketamine.
Usually the fire service would cut the spike and it would only be removed in an operating theatre.
I think it's far too close to his hand. Yeah, so it's not ideal taking his hand out of it, but I think it's the only option we've got at the moment.
Yeah,
okay.
But removing the spike is not without risk. Nerves and blood vessels could be further damaged, but the infection risk is lessened.
So what we're going to do is we're going to give you a real strong painkiller.
Yeah.
It's going to make you feel real odd. It's going to help you out with that pain. Okay.
Yeah.
Trust us.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then what we're going to do, because of how close your hand is to this metal, we're just going to pull it out. All right.
They're preparing for heavy bleeding when Wayne is freed.
Andy, can you draw me some antibiotics up? Get me some Celox ready. And also a bag of saline, please.
They're giving him ketamine, a powerful painkiller.
Right, Wayne, keep talking to me. I want you to keep talking to me so you can tell me how you're feeling. As soon as we know that this is taking effect, then we'll start moving your hand, all right?
But the hand is full of nerve endings, and Wayne is still in unbearable pain.
Do you know what dad is?
It's half an hour since Wayne fell.
Friday.
He needs hospital care. Firefighters are ready to carry him out of the piggery.
Bloody hell.
Wayne is remarkably resistant to the ketamine. He's still in great pain.
90 milligrams so far. 90.
He's been given twice the usual dose.
Do you feel any different at all, Wayne?
Yeah.
Huh? Has that pain gone at all? Has it touched it at all?
They have to increase the dose again.
This cat might start seeing some action now, eh?
Wayne?
Yeah. Do you feel me still touching your hand?
Yeah.
Good. It's working, is it?
Oh, yeah, my eyes are tight.
Oh, good stuff.
Oh.
Right, you keep thinking happy thoughts, all right? Good lad, well done.
At last, it seems to be having some effect. They're ready to free him.
Turn your hand over for me.
You're all right.
Turn your hand.
Use it as a bit of a wipe, you know.
Brilliant, well done. It's all done now. It's all done, Puddy. All right.
Happily, Wayne will remember little of this, but ketamine can give patients hallucinations.
Well done.
I'm not dead.
No.
No.
Wayne, open your eyes for me. Look. Everything's all right. Everything's all right. Everything's okay. Relax, open your eyes if you want. Look at us. It's all sorted, okay?
It's been a terrifying ordeal for Wayne. He was working among his pigs. Now, his open wound means they pose a major risk to his health.
All right, Wayne. Good lad.
We're going to take this patient to Hull, which is the local major trauma centre. We've padded his hand up now, we've irrigated him with some clean fluids, give him some antibiotics, and we'll get him to hospital. And hopefully everything will be all right.
Wayne depends on his hands for his living, and it could be a long road to recovery.
One of the things with ketamine you get, whenever it wears off, you come out of it and all the sensations that you didn't have hit you very quickly, and you get quite confused and disoriented, so that's what I'm watching for now. Obviously we're in an aircraft, don't want him to either harm himself here.
At Hull Royal Infirmary, surgeons are preparing to examine his injuries. Farmer Wayne underwent a three-hour operation on his badly injured hand. Surgeons warned him it would take a year to regain full use of it, but he's now back at work with his pigs.